Cameron, I can't believe we are here finally. We've been through so much. We'd be here for a long time if I had to list all the ways you've made me a better man. There's nobody else I'd rather talk to after a rough day, and no one's opinion I value more than yours. You decided to move here, uprooting your life, leaving your family and friends behind, to give us a chance, and for that I'll be forever grateful. And trust me when I say that, we wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for you. I get to laugh with you, I get to cry with you, I get to live with you, and I get to grow with you. I don't have to cherish you, but it's an honour to.
It's most definitely been a bumpy 18 months, with a number of hardships and a certain amount of uncertainty and anxiety. You've both worked so incredibly hard in supporting one another, keeping your love strong and holding your heads high.
Cameron has made Craig the happiest he has ever been. Your relationship represents three things: persistence, patience, and passion. You spent so long apart in the early days that everyday life together is just so precious. And I think it's clear for everyone here today to see that the smallest things were well worth the wait.
Say, growing up, Craig was a handful, would be an understatement. But I'm sure we all agree that he has turned out to be a kind, caring son. And I know your mum would be proud.
So Craig has always been a really good best friend, reliable, loving, and very trustworthy. But having you, Cam, in his life has made him even more so. He's settled, even more ambitious, and he's such a devoted partner, but still makes so much time for his friends.
Craig, your kind, caring, and compassionate manner, along with your endless devotion to Cam, is all I could ever want for my best friend. Cam, your passion and drive for life inspires me every single day. You shower your nearest and dearest with endless amounts of love and affection. And no matter what life throws at you, you tackle it face on and put your all into striving to achieve your goals.
Craig, I'm so happy he found you. And for the love of God, he's yours. I love you both, and I wish you both the happiness.
Joanne and me had heard about Cam, and Craig invited us to see them both on the ship. On the last day of the cruise, Craig was working, so Cam met us and for lunch and asked if he could ask Craig to marry him. Both me and Joe cried. No, not not because we was pleased to get rid of him, but we could see how both happy they were.
Not a day has gone by since I met you that I've doubted my love and commitment to you. Through the past few years, and especially the past year, where you've given me everything I could have ever needed to be happy. This day has been so long coming, and you have held me in your arms more times than I care to count, to comfort me and tell me everything was going to be okay, even if we weren't sure it was going to be. You're such a hard worker, and you never think of yourself first, and that's why I love you. I promise to work harder every day to give you the best life possible, in that no matter what others think, that we know that we're on the right path. I promise to deep down love you even when I'm hangry. I haven't eaten anything yet today. So I'm trying to stay positive. I promise to let you choose the paint color for the spare bedroom from the four that I've previously picked. And most importantly, I promise to apologize first. Well, let's be honest, you're still going to apologize first. But even through our stubbornness, we both know how much we love each other. And above all, I promise to stand by you as your husband through the hard times, the good times, and as we go through life together. I love you.
Craig have brought us together here for an occasion of great joy and a cause for great celebration. They have chosen each one of you to be here with them to witness their wedding vows as they join together as husband and husband. This is also a celebration of the union of friends and family, for a marriage needs the help of a community of friends and family who will be there when needed and will do all that they can during the hard times to stand by Cameron and Craig and offer their support to them and the new family that they create today. Was my closest friend, but then you came and he soon departed, and you know he never showed his face again. That's why your love
would everyone be upstanding to toast the new Mr. and Mr. Cumby?
And face the world. Let me tell you, your love keep on lifting me higher.
This day has been so long coming, and when it finally got to this morning, we just didn't think it was real. And even after a year and a half of dresses and suits and changes of suits and changes of dresses and changes of dresses and... So thank you all for coming today, and I really never drink, but I'm gonna get drunk tonight. So raise your glasses and your speeches. Thank you, everybody.
I'll be your dream, I'll be your wish, I'll be your fantasy.
Cameron, with this wedding ring, I am giving you my promise.
To always love you.
To always love you.
Cherish you.
Cherish you.
Honour you.
Honour you.
And comfort you.
And comfort you.
I promise that I will love you.
I promise that I will love you.
And keep my heart open to you.
And keep my heart open to you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I wanna stand with you on a mountain.
Sweaty.
All right. It was surrounded by the comfort and protection of the highest powers.
Ladies and gentlemen,
After 4 cancellations, rebookings, endless trips to the seamstress with refittings, it is my privilege to present to you Mr. and Mr. Cumby. I wrote a poem. This poem is called Craig's Journey to Love. When me and Craig got to secondary school, I made a bet with his mum, who giggled, then shook my hand on a £50 sum. She was sure Craig would settle down with a kind and thoughtful Jewish wife. I was sure he had already decided he wanted a man for life. From Fairy Gate to stage school and all the dodgy outfits and characters in between, to announcing I'm gay and dropping Mike at his party as he turned 18. Everyone knows he loves love, and like us all, has had others come and go, leaving no real impression. Enter Cam, someone who had an immediate effect, leading to them both wanting to pop the question. You have both shown insane amounts of sacrifice in order to start your life together as a pair, and then a pandemic hit and it did not seem fair. I think, if anything, you have shown you can get through the worst. Anything that tries to test you from here on out will be a breeze, because soz hun, but COVID got there first. You have both been through it all in a short amount of time. The sky is the limit now, boys, so as a married couple, go out and shine. Cam, as a message from what I personally think is the best bridal party that ever was or will be, we are now handing over our brother, our friend, our slaz, and our BFG. So please ensure you handle with care, but we do know what he can be like, so if you need us to tell him off, we will be there. Craig's journey to love has been entertaining, but it has come to an end, and I could not be prouder of my best friend. So if everybody could hold up their glasses and repeat these words of advice after me. There's gonna be blood, sweat, and tears. Oh, let's try that again, guys. There's gonna be blood, sweat, and tears. There's gonna be hard work and fears. But I ain't gonna stop. No, never stop. Till I got you.
Till I got you.
Cheers. And if you don't know that song, you probably had friends at school.